Hi and welcome back. In this module, you will learn how to annotate images. It is a more advanced stuff respect to what you have done so far. So expect to be a little bit more challenged, but you will see it's not that difficult in the end. It's just a couple of concepts. How good are you in geometry? Shall we see? So when you have images, sometimes you don't want just to align one page of image with one page of transcription. You may want to do it at a smaller granularity, for instance, a paragraph or a line. Or you may want to annotate and discuss what is in the image. Maybe you're interested on the nice doodles or miniatures or something like that. So it may happen that you would like to zone, to cut some regions within your image to be able to connect at a much smaller granularity. How do you do that? The TI uses the facsimile module. We have seen already that. We see how it works more in details and more in depth. In particular, we will see how to use the element called zone. Zone is in fact the one that is able to say, well, this is a particular area of my image that I like to talk something about or I like to connect to a transcription. The dimension and the position of this zone with respect to the whole image is done thanks to coordinates, Cartesian coordinates, which are expressed with the help of four particular attributes, which are ULX, ULY, LRX, LRY. I never remember them, so I need to check them all the time. We shall see how it works in practice. So if you look at your image, the one you see on the screen at the moment, you have to imagine that the zero of your Cartesian axis is not where they taught you at school, which is the bottom corner on the left, but it's the upper corner. So that is your origin. So whenever you have to design a square or a rectangle of your image, this is defined by giving the points of the corner of that rectangle. And not all four rectangle corners, but just the upper left and the bottom right. And each point, these two corners, is defined by two sets of coordinates, the X and the Y, the X and the Y. On both cases. So in the image, for instance, you see that there is a rectangle there. The bottom corner, which is it's defined with an X, which is 560, and the Y, which is 171. While the upper corner is defined with an X of 57 and a Y of 91. So this is very important. You have to remember that the definition starts from the top corner to the bottom corner. So once you have done how you record them, you put them in those attributes we said before. So the upper corner of your rectangle, which is 5791, go in the ULX, so upper left X 57, and the upper left Y 91. While the second corner, the one on the bottom, it goes on LRX, left right X, 560, and the LRY, lower right Y, 171. Okay, is that clear? I know it's not the easiest things to do, but the image there and the example should be clear enough. And also very important that you put an XML ID to your zone, because if you want to connect that to transcription, that's where you need to have some referencing system in place. So how do you do that? Once you've had this encoding, you can, inside the zone, put an element note in which you explain the content of this zone. And that is when you want to annotate your image, when you want to describe. For instance, if you are an art historian, you can use this to annotate the beautiful miniature of a medieval manuscript, or to describe what is in there. Or what you could do also is to connect this zone that you have just defined to which you add an XML ID attribute to your transcription. And you can do at any level. So the fax attribute that we saw before attached to the PB element in reality can be attached to any element in your transcription to a character level. In this example, we have defined a zone that groups the first paragraph of the Gettysburg Address. Therefore, I've used my fax attribute within the element P. And remember, I use the hash whenever I want to connect the two things. So the XML ID declares my identifier, the hash followed by the same value creates the connection. You will ask, how do I know the coordinates of my boxes? Well, there are several tools that you can use to do that. Some are more easy than others. One easy and very nice tool is called IMT, Image Markup Tool, but works only on PC, on Windows machine. Or you could use, which is a multi-platform one, which is called Inkscape, which is extremely powerful, but is also a bit complicated to learn. There is also a plugin for Oxygen, but I do find it a bit sometimes cumbersome to use. It's okay, you can try it. I put in the slides the link you can download and install in Oxygen. It works a treat when it is installed properly. Or you can use a very simple tool that is web-based, so you don't need to install anything in your computer, and simply go on a website and do your zoning. This is called the TI Zoner and has been developed by Chris Sparks. How does it work? So first you go on this website, the TI Zoner one, and you upload your file. There is a place that says pick an image. So you click there and you look in your computer where your image is and you upload the file. Once you've done that, then you start drawing your boxes. And how you do that? You do by clicking the top left corner and the bottom right corner of your rectangle. Remember, the TI works top left, bottom right. Once you have done that and you see that circle, there's a very tiny little dot, so sometimes you can miss them, then you can click on the bottom bar where you say draw rectangle. And once you've done that, the rectangle will appear. So now you have your rectangle in the image. You can just reveal the code. There is show TI button at the bottom. You can click on that and then you see the code. You find your XML right there. Now to use it is very simple. You just copy it and paste it in your Oxygen, in your file within an element surface, as in for the example. You can draw as many boxes as you want and then copy them all at once, or you can copy and do it one by one. Remember, this is just a tool for drawing. It will not remember your image. Once you change website, you change page, it will just disappear. So it's important you copy and paste while you do all your boxing.